Thank you for telling it on the mountain.
My way.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. Amen. 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 Welcome and good morning once again to our first Sunday in Christmas time. And so I want to welcome you to the day after Christmas and, of course, the time in which we celebrate the birth of Christ and look forward to the growth of Christ as he goes through this Christmas time into the new year. And so I want to share with you just briefly that no matter what day, week, month, year we are in, no matter how bad it seems to be, with God in our lives, nothing is insurmountable. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. I just think sometimes we get overwhelmed with things, and so I don't want us to ever think that God is not with us, even in those times when we think we're on our own. All right? All right?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Now we're going to have laughter the best medicine. I lost that mask. This one doesn't have the tree on it.
Amen to that.
Now we will have the lighting of the Christmas candles. I am so sorry.
We'll give you one then. We'll give you one.
Thank you.
Let us pray that we may know the warmth and brightness of Jesus Christ and show Christ's love to the world. Risen Christ, light of the world, shine in our lives and shine among us now. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Good morning, Aldersgate family.
Good morning.
And happy day after Christmas. I trust your Christmas was peaceful, restful, and joyous.
Amen.
And it was so nice to see the lighting of the Christmas candle and know that we're not letting go yet of the Christmas spirit. I think that's what's so lovely about the season is it kind of ramps up everybody's kindness and generosity. And that's a wonderful thing. It's just that, as Pastor Bertrand, we need to hold on to that for the rest of the year. So, Aldersgate family, I think that's our homework assignment for 2022, to have that Christmas spirit all year long. So, at this moment, do we have any announcements that need to be shared? Yes, Neil.
Thank you, Peter. I'm coming up there. I'm going to take about 10 minutes out of there.
10 minutes, okay.
It'll take
you 10 minutes to get up here.
Yeah. Well, that's true. I'm glad to be walking.
Amen. You better preach.
Ladies and gentlemen, I've had a lot of requests from you as a you look around the churchyard and see there's no leaves left. There are five or six of us that love that because they were all raked up.
Amen.
The shrubbery's been trimmed. There's just, it looks beautiful out there. And I wanted to recognize the person that was responsible for it, Mr. Tom Waynes and his group out of Elizabeth City. You did a wonderful job, Tom, and your crew, and please pass that so when Tom gave that to the church, it's a Christmas gift.
Amen.
Amen. Wanted y'all to know that and know who did it and who was responsible, because it wasn't me. Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
Wow. Thanks, Tom.
Dear Kathy, that is my beautiful daughter, number two.
Oh, three, Shayla Ace, nice to see you.
Who will be getting married, signing in. She's getting married in June of next year.
For 2022, so if you're on the counting team, you'll pick one up when you leave, so you'll be prepared next year.
Okay, you heard that. If you're on the counting schedule, pick up the schedule out in our
class. I have a quick announcement, please, Ms. Kathy.
Okay, great.
My beloved family, Aldersgate, have been with me for 4 months, and I feel the love. I've been feeling the love for 4 months. Thank you so much for your beautiful Christmas cards and wonderful expressions in those cards. And thank you for your generous gift. I love you. It's my honor, my joy, my pleasure. Bless it. Just thank you, Lord, for this family. Thank you, Lord. I'm happy to be here. Thank you for inviting me.
Well, that's wonderful. She's still telling it on now.
You better know it. My way.
Yes?
Hey, Neil, we still have a meeting after church for the trustees.
Okay.
Just for a reminder.
So there's a meeting after church for the trustees.
Okay. Huh?
Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. I knew you forgot.
All right. So if we now, if there aren't any more announcements, I assume there aren't. If there aren't, can we bow our heads and pray over today's service? Lord, on this day, the day after so many presents have been opened, we set our hearts on you. You are trustworthy, faithful, and the giver of the gift of peace. Bless Pastor Bert as he purposes to underscore that truth. As we take in your word today, fill us with your peace and equip us to be a balm for this battle. We ask this in the precious name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
All right, beloved, let's stand to our feet. Joy to the world. We have much to be grateful for. Without the birth of Christ, we wouldn't have the resurrection of Christ. We would have eternal life. So let's sing Joy to the World, all four stanzas.
Thank you.
sounding joy. Repeat the sounding joy.
My joy is that my brother-in-law is here with me this morning. Just wait. I didn't want to embarrass him really, but thank you, Pastor. Any other joy or any other concerns?
We are about to move into our new place. So, we heard that we are close enough to hear it written.
Do you have a date yet?
Not yet.
Not yet. They're planning on moving into their own place pretty soon. No date yet, but it is imminent, and it is not too far from church, so we still are able to have them come in to church every Sunday. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Are there any other joys or any other concerns? Let us bow our heads. Almighty God, this morning we thank you for this day. This day after Christmas. This day after the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ. But Lord, every day is a good day because you are with us and you are guiding us through each one. We thank you for your blessing. We thank you for our families that we were able to visit with. We thank you for all the time we were able to spend with each other and celebrate the true reason for this season. We thank you for just guiding us each and every day. Gracious Lord, as we prepare our hearts to go into the new year, help us. Help us to leave whatever baggage is in this year in this year. Help us to look forward through the windshield and not in the rearview mirror. Help us to see forward and not looking over our shoulders. Help us to see each new day as a dawning that allows for us to see you in our lives in some magnificent way. We look forward to this coming Sunday and this coming Saturday when we embark on a new year. And we look to you for each of those days to be a blessing to all of us. We thank you for your Son's birth, but we know, Lord, that the story didn't end there because he lived a full and sinless life. He lived perfectly among us, but he also felt all of the challenges that he had. He was joyous on occasion, but he was also sad. He was angry on occasion, but he also celebrated the triumphs in our lives. so that he could fully experience everything that we go through, so he can understand more fully all that we do and we go through, and have all of the empathy that anyone could have, but even more so because he is the Son of God. We thank you for his life. We thank you for the lessons he taught. We thank you for those who follow him, and because of their following him, we have the good news to follow him today. We thank you for his disciples, the ones who asked questions and the ones that sat contemplating what he shared with them. We thank you because you gave them a prayer to share that we still share even in this day. That prayer is, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
Okay, Aldersgate, let's stand and sing one of my favorites. I love them all. But, O Come, All Ye Faithful. I don't know how many stands do you have? Three?
Four.
My music says, is there four? Okay, let's sing all four stanzas, please. All four stanzas of O Come, All Ye Faithful.
Joyful footsteps.
remember to keep in prayer those that we have prayed for over this past year, and those that we continue to lift up our offering to serve in this community. Let us come forward through the center aisle and return to our seats through the aisle. Let us come at this time.
Big hand clap. And of course, I couldn't do it by myself. Well, I could, but I'm not going to. Give Gary a big hand clap, please. They are our vocal. All right.
Sharing that with us this morning. I haven't heard that song in quite a while, so thank you. I remember most of the words, actually.
Well, you just bat off on yourself as well.
Our scripture this morning comes from the book of Matthew, chapter 16, verses 13 through 16. Matthew, chapter 16, verses 13 through 16. When Jesus came to the region of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, "What do people say the Son of Man is?" Who do people say the Son of Man is? They replied, "Some say John the Baptist, others say Elijah, and still others, Jeremiah or one of the prophets." "But what about you?" he asked. "Who do you say I am?" Simon Peter answered, "You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God." This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Amen. Amen. Let us bow our heads. Almighty God, this morning, there are so many who still don't know who you are. There are still so many that question who you are. There are so many that doubt. But Lord, in no uncertain terms, show us who you truly are. Help us to know in no uncertain terms that no matter where we go and no matter who is asking us, we can share the gospel news that you are the Son of the living God. We thank you for being our salvation. We thank you for being with us and guiding us. And we thank you for continuing to love us so much. Now show us who you are in only a way that you can. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen. This morning, we have heard so many times when people say, "Well, I've heard of this Jesus Christ, but who really is he? Who is he and what is he about?" And so this morning, if you ever doubted who Jesus was, let's learn a little bit more about who the risen Christ truly is. Mm-hmm. You know, during this Advent season, our past Advent season, we talked about waiting for the coming Christ. But we still ask sometimes, who is this coming Christ? Who is Jesus? But before we answer that, let me set the scene. You've seen people do interviews on the street, just randomly walking up to someone. And let's set this scene as New York City, why not, Times Square, midday. Mm-hmm. And this crew of cameras and reporters are walking up to you and your friends. And they ask you, "Who is Jesus Christ?" And before long, you're standing there stumbling, wondering, and your friends back up at least 5 feet. Because they didn't ask them, they asked you. To your surprise, their questions have nothing to do with the White House or politics or the economy or where you stand on health reform. They just want to know who you think Jesus Christ is. Mm-hmm. And while you fumble for the answer, the video camera records your discomfort. You weren't prepared for this, much less dressed for it. And now you're being quizzed on theology while your friends watch from a distance. The seconds pass as various answers flash across your mental screen, like, "He's a good man. He's a prophet. He's the Son of God." Which answer will you give? But before you answer, let me say this, that you can find people today who will give every one of those answers. Does that surprise you? It should. After 2,000 years, we still wonder who this man is that we call Jesus. But that's nothing new. When Jesus asked his disciples, "Who do people say I am?" they replied with those four different answers. Even when he walked on this earth, people were confused as to his true identity. Some thought he was a prophet, others a great political leader. Still others thought he was John the Baptist come back to life. Mm-hmm. One question, many answers. One man, many faces. There are people who have modern versions of Jesus, and I just want us to start by surveying some of these modern versions. First, as we heard earlier, the good man. We start with this view because it is no doubt the most popular face of Jesus. Ask any 10 non-religious people on the street who Jesus is, and 8 of them will say something like, he was a good man who lived long ago. Of all the modern versions of Jesus, this one is both the closest to the truth and also the deadliest of errors. Jesus was a good man. He went around doing good, referring to his miracles. But to stop there is to miss the central truth of his divine personality. Yes, he was a good man, but he is also the Son of God from heaven who came to be the Savior of the world. Another version is the revolutionary Jesus. This view was popular in the 60s when left-wing radicals appropriated Jesus as the Messiah who came to overthrow the unjust power structures of his day and to bring in the kingdom through protest and nonviolent action. As many people have pointed out, Jesus was indeed revolutionary, but not in the sense intended by those who use that term. Jesus came to start a revolution of love on planet Earth. He wasn't concerned about overthrowing governments, but about overthrowing sin in the human heart. The revolutionary Jesus. What about the ecumenical Christ? This is the option for people who like Jesus but don't want to worship him exclusively. They lump him together with other notable religious leaders such as Confucius or Gandhi and Buddha and Muhammad. Such people have a Mount Rushmore religion. When they look up, they see 4 or 5 faces peering down from heaven. Jesus is one of the faces they see. Pick the one you like and worship him. Many people believe in the ecumenical Christ because it's a convenient way to call yourself a Christian and still be open-minded about other options. In order to answer the question that was asked earlier, who is Jesus Christ? We have to go back to the New Testament. And when we do, 4 important facts emerge that form the answer to history's greatest question. First, Christ made amazing claims. Here's a fact not often appreciated by non-religious people. Jesus made absolutely astounding claims about himself. In fact, if you catalog his own words, you must conclude that either he is who he said he is or else he is a liar.
All right, now.
The people who say Jesus was a good man, nothing more, have never read the gospel. Because you could never come to that conclusion if you actually read what Jesus said about himself. Like, he claimed to be the Son of God. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. He claimed that angels obeyed him. The Son of Man will send out his angels. He claimed to possess all power in heaven and on earth. All authority in heaven and on earth have been given to me. He claimed the power to forgive sin. Friends, your sins are forgiven. He claimed to be the giver of eternal life. I give them eternal life. And if you want the reference scriptures, talk to me after service. The second fact is about his supernatural power. When John the Baptist was in prison, he sent his disciples to Jesus with a very poignant question. Are you the one, or are we to wait for another? Jesus answered by listing the miracles he had performed. The blind see, the deaf hear, the lame walk. The lepers are cleansed. The dead are raised back to life. No one could fake such miracles as those. No religious charlatan could give sight to the blind. Not even the great Houdini could raise the dead. Only the mighty Son of God could work such awesome miracles. Anyone can claim to work miracles in their own power, But only Jesus can do it. His life was marked by miraculous power, which is exactly what you would expect from the Son of God. What about fact number three, the empty tomb? This, of course, is the ultimate proof. It is also the ultimate question. Did Jesus really rise from the dead? And we'll get that answer a little bit later on at Easter. All right. If he did, then he really is the Son of God. If he didn't, then he is not the Son of God. In fact, if he didn't, not only is he not a good man, but the world's greatest faker.
All right.
And we are fools to follow him. To deny the resurrection and you've removed the supernatural heart of the Christian faith. If you don't really believe that Jesus rose from the dead, you're not a Christian in the true sense of the term. The entire Christian faith hangs on this one fact. Jesus rose from the dead. Literally, physically, bodily, visibly. It is the testimony of the empty tomb and all of those that witness him that forever sets Jesus apart from all other religious leaders. They are dead. He lives. The fourth fact is that so many lives have been transformed by Jesus' life, his death, and his resurrection. Let's call it Rome. Today, over 2 billion people bear the name Christian. That tiny band of followers has spread to every nation on every continent. Yes, including Antarctica. There are people living there that are Christians. Thousands more join the ranks every single day. To put matters in perspective, more people have come to Christ in the last generation than in the previous 2,000 years. History shows that Jesus Christ continues to change lives 20 centuries after he walked the dusty roads of Galilee and braved the narrow cobblestone streets of Jerusalem. Yet today, he is the single most influential person in all human history. More influential than Oprah, more influential than the Kennedys or anyone else. Listen to the words of Napoleon Bonaparte after he was exiled. He came to this stunning conclusion. I know men, and I tell you that Jesus Christ is not mere man. Between him and every other person in the world, there is no possible term of comparison. Alexander, Caesar, Charlemagne, and myself, Napoleon put himself in that bunch, have found and formed great empires. But Jesus alone founded his empire upon love, and to this very day, millions would die for him. Mm-hmm. Are we willing to die for Christ? Mm-hmm. Die to self daily, and give ourselves to God. I want to mention to you that after Jesus had asked his disciples, who do people say that I am? He asked them more personally, who do you say that I am? When Peter answered, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God, he uttered the words that became the foundation of the worldwide Christian movement. That, in one short sentence, is what Christians believe about Jesus. We confess our revolutionary truth that Jesus of Nazareth is the Son of the living God.
Amen.
In short, we believe something very special about someone special. We believe that a man once walked this earth who was like no other man who ever lived. We believe he did things no other man has ever done. In fact, you remember the Apostles' Creed? I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. And in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day, he rose from the dead and ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father. But we're not done. I believe in the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Holy Catholic Church. The communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. This is what we proclaim to believe. Where do you stand? And you don't have to answer out loud, but you have to have an answer. Who is Jesus Christ? A good man? A great teacher? A revolutionary leader? Or is he the Christ, the anointed, the Son of the living God? This answer will change how you look at God and how you tell others about what Christ has done for you. Your eternal destiny hangs on your answer. May God open your eyes to see Jesus as the Son of God. And may the Holy Spirit grant you faith to believe in him. For through that faith, you will be able to share the message that has been shared throughout the ages.
Amen.
When someone would ask in the Middle Ages, who is Jesus Christ? He's the Son of the living God. When someone in the last century would ask, they may give more of a detailed answer, but they still essentially would say, he is the Son of the living God. Mm-hmm. That's all you have to share. And if they want to have any further discussion or get a more in-depth answer, continue to just share what you have learned about Christ. So the next time you hear the question, who is Jesus Christ? This is your answer.
Amen.
This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Amen. Amen.
Amen, Pastor. Beloved Aldersgate, hark! Listen. The herald angels sing. Let's sing. Stand up, my angels.
Gracious Lord, You have shown us in no uncertain terms who your Son is, Jesus Christ. We thank you for sharing him with us. And we thank you for the love that came from you by sharing him with us. Now, Lord, as we have been asked and will continue to be asked, who is the Son of the living God? And we shall say, Jesus the Christ, the Anointed. He is the Son of the living God. Let others come and ask that question throughout eternity, that we may answer, Jesus is the Son of the living God. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray.